Kate Raworth is an Oxford macroeconomist. She's part of a new generation of post-growth economists. She wrote Donut Economics and gave an excellent TED Talk called A Healthy Economy Should Be Designed to Thrive, Not Grow. She's asking all sorts of interesting questions about growth on the national level, GDP. Why does the economy always have to be up and to the right? The moment that our economy starts to flatten out, what happens? Recession, layoffs, suffering. But why? She and the other post-growth economists explain that there's too much extraction happening from our economies. This can occur in the form of dividends, like shareholders, and exits, so think of IPOs, mergers, acquisitions, and stock buybacks. All of these situations result in a large payoff for the investors and founders. But this is pulling financial value out of our businesses, and therefore our economies. I believe that this value extraction creates the 99% and the 1%. If you were to eliminate the extraction, we'd be able to start to flatten our economies without them falling apart. But the problem is, there's so much extraction happening from our economies that the economy needs to continue growing just to maintain a steady state. This is the fundamental problem. How can we solve this? Well, let's first consider the nature of an economy. It's a meta-concept, an aggregate of all businesses, individuals, governments, educational institutions, NGOs, etc. All of us together form the economy. If we want to change the composition of the economy, we need to start thinking about how we can create new forms of business. We need to ask ourselves, if we want to implement a flat post-growth economy, what kind of businesses do we need to build? Kate Raworth also talks about the false concept of the market externality. Basic economic market models only consider supply and demand. They ignore external factors that contribute to the market but don't shift capital around. This includes unpaid labor, health costs, environmental costs, etc. She argues that market externalities don't exist. See, everything is input into the system. It's just a question of whether or not we acknowledge this. She also asks questions about growth curves of individual organizations. Business tends to be about exponential curves. These are found everywhere, in every MBA program, every startup incubator, every pitch deck, pop culture, you name it, it's hard to get away from it. We are always thinking about scaling. But why? Where did this come from? And is it necessary? And is there an alternative? We can look at nature for counterexamples. Take any living creature, for example, a tree, a dog, or a human child. It doesn't really matter. Let's use a tree. A tree grows very quickly, almost exponentially, at the beginning of its life. However, then that growth starts to slow down. The growth curve flattens out when the tree has reached its maximum size, and the tree stops growing, and it starts thriving. If the tree wants to continue growing, it spreads seeds. Those seeds then grow into little trees, and those trees grow until they reach their maximum size, and so on. The question is, if this is how nature does it, then why is it any different with our businesses? There's one example in nature of something that grows forever. It's sometimes malignant. It might kill you. But beyond cancer, I also heard an anecdote one time about a particular kind of deer that has horns that grow exponentially forever. The horns grow until it eventually snaps the deer's neck. So exponential growth isn't working for nature. Why then does it inspire how we do business? And where did we get this idea from anyway?